This morning's lessons point to the blessed results of redemption in our lives. The Old Testament lesson deals with a new covenant God will make with Israel, dealing with our changed hearts and forgiveness. The Old Testament reading is taken from the 31st chapter of Jeremiah, beginning with the 31st verse. "The time is coming, declares the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant I made with their forefathers when I took them by the hand to lead them out of Egypt, because they broke my covenant, though I was a husband to them, declares the Lord. This is the covenant I will make with the house of Israel after that time, declares the Lord. I will put my law in their minds and will write it on their hearts. I will be their God, and they will be my people. No longer will a man teach his neighbor, or a man his brother, saying, 'Know the Lord,' because they will all know me, from the least of them to the greatest, declares the Lord. For I will forgive their wickedness and remember their sins no more." Here endeth the Old Testament reading. But thou, O Lord, have mercy on us. The epistle speaks of our Savior made perfect through suffering and therefore winning our salvation. The epistle reading is taken from the 5th chapter of Hebrews, beginning with the 7th verse. During the days of Jesus' life on earth, he offered up prayers and petition with loud cries and tears to the one who could save him from death, and he was heard because of his reverent submission. Although he was a son, he learned obedience from what he had suffered, and, once made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him. Here endeth the epistle reading. But thou, O Lord, have mercy on us. The Holy Gospel shows our Savior announcing the coming of the time of his glorification, through which he will draw all people to himself. Please rise to the reading of the Holy Gospel. The Holy Gospel is taken from the 12th chapter of St. John, beginning with the 20th verse. Now there were some Greeks among those who went up to worship at the feast. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, with a request. "Sir," they said, "we would like to see Jesus." Philip went to tell Andrew. Andrew and Philip, in turn, told Jesus. Jesus replied, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. I tell you the truth, unless a kernel of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains only a single seed. But if it dies, it produces many seeds. The man who loves his life will lose it, while the man who hates his life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, my servant also will be. My Father will honor the one who serves me. Now my heart is troubled, and what shall I say? Father, save me from this hour? No, it was for this very reason I came to this hour. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice came from heaven, "I have glorified it and will glorify it again." The crowd that was there and heard it said it had thundered. Others said an angel had spoken to him. Jesus said, "This voice was for your benefit, not mine. Now is the time for judgment on this world. Now the prince of this world will be driven out. But I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all men to myself." He said this to show the kind of death he was going to die. Here endeth the reading of the Gospel.